other materials in this module mention that there is a web version of Zotero, and you might also have noticed it while you're creating your account. You can see now that it is set up very similarly to the desktop version with the left column, the center column, and the right-hand column, but it doesn't have the same functionality as the desktop version. So I just wanted to clarify what the web version can and can't do and explain why you still need to download the desktop version. So you'll notice that up here on the top toolbar, you do have the ability to add new items. This is only for manually adding items. You can't import easily into the web version like you can the desktop version. You have to, and you'll see that in the next module. If you were to click on this journal article option, for example, it creates a blank item and then you fill out the information manually here. You do, however, have the option to add by identifier. If you click what we call the magic wand in the desktop version, you can type in a URL, ISBN, DOI, PMID, or archive ID, and Zotero will automatically grab the information or as much information as it can for that resource that you're adding. But it doesn't include the PDF, and you don't even have the ability to attach PDFs to sources in the web version. That can only be done in the desktop version. The other reason you need the desktop version is if you're going to be using the Zotero connector, that can only work if you have the desktop version open on your computer. So the web version is mostly just for being able to access your Zotero reference sources from any device. You can always log into the Zotero website to see your items without having to be on a computer where the desktop app is downloaded. And you can quickly add things, but it cannot fully replace the desktop app version. However, it's good to know that it's here because you never know when you're going to need it.